Hey there, greetings to you all. Welcome to Sambhava Innovations. You are listening to Dilip Kumar Sakkim Setty. I proudly welcome you to the learning management system of New Vision School, New Vision e-learning platform, a website to manage all the learning activity of the student or the children and the content creation from the faculty. So the agenda of our tutorial today is how to create a lesson inside a course. The prerequisites before we begin this session are you must be having a learn user ID and password, unique user ID and password. The target audience for this tutorial are faculties in New Vision. So the prerequisites part, if you have a user ID and password, you will be able to log in inside. And then to do any changes in a course or a subject in this particular platform, the backend team could have already mapped you to your relevant course. Just let's say, for example, if you are a subject teacher for mathematics in class 8, so the backend team could have already given you permissions to manage the content in the mathematics class 8 subject. So with this prerequisites, let me begin our session today. So I have logged into the newvision.in website, and this is the home page. And just to demonstrate our session today, I would like to give you a mock-up. So I'm just selecting any of the categories we have, the campuses. So I have checked inside the Senior Foundation. So if it is in your case, you must select your own campus and then select your own class that you are wishing to do any modification. Here I am checking inside Titans. So you might be finding your subjects or list of subjects inside this Titan 1-4, and let me pick any subject. I am choosing physics, and if you are a subject teacher for mathematics, you'll be selecting this, and if it is for English, you'll be choosing English. So I have logged inside physics, and then you see here there is a button, turn editing on and off. If you, by default, this button is in this mode, turn editing on, matlab this is off condition. So I'll turn it on first. Yeah, I have turned that on, and here you see the list of contents already visible to the students. So the first box, whatever is present inside this first box, I request all the faculties, do not touch this area, because we exclusively use this space to create any announcements in this particular subject. Yeah, so here we have topic 1, 2, 3, 4. Please do not get confused that the topic 1, 2, 3, 4 named here are not actually the topics. So they are only for your reference. You should actually rename them. So in my use case, I'll treat this topic as a lesson. Hence, I would like to rename this particular topic. Yeah, I'll click on this pencil button here for editing, and I'll, let us say, for example, I'll rename this as lesson number 1. Okay, alright. Yeah, here you see there is a button called add an activity or a resource. As I have said in the beginning of the tutorial, we are gonna learn how to create a lesson inside this course. Hence I'm selecting lesson here. You see, we have checked inside, and so since we are starting a lesson inside this lesson 1, there must be a name of the lesson. So since I have chosen physics, let me give some random name, reflection of light at curved surfaces. So I have given the title of the lesson, and then there are few changes that you must remember to modify before you click on save. So the appearance part, you need not touch this. Availability, if this course should only be enabled for 1 year or 1 month or 1 week, you can choose the duration here, but since we are not doing this, let us not touch anything here. And the flow control, again, maximum number of attempts. Here there is given only number 1. Even though we have to change this option, let us not touch this area again here for now. And the grade, I'll directly jump to the what is needed. Retakes allowed. Retakes allowed, it should be marked as yes. What exactly is this retakes? I'll tell you how. Let's say a student logged in, he has viewed the content present inside this course one single time. And if the student wishes to watch it again, the website or this complete learning system doesn't allow him to take it again because you have not allowed him to retake it. What I did, I have given a permission to retake the session. Now, we have actually allowed the student to view the content multiple times, just not once, it can be n number of times. And then the common module settings, yes, you need not touch that. Restrict access, we are not restricting any permission for any students at the moment. Activation completion state, you are not touching this again. And let me conclude, just give save and display. Save and display, I have clicked it. Here you go. Directly in the first page, just after entering your heading of the lesson, it is displayed like this, and you can see a list of 4 options. All these 4 options are very vital in creating and delivering the content to the student. Every change that you make here is directly going to impact on the learning of a student. Hence, I would request every faculty and a teacher to pay attention with utmost care. You should choose every single option inside this course content creation. So let's begin with adding a content page. Importing, let me say one after the other. Importing questions is just like if you have something written inside a notepad or somewhere, you can just import them. Let us skip this part. Add a content page, the second one. Adding a content. If you were to deliver any content to the student, either you will be delivering the content in the form of a text, image, GIF file, animation, video lecture, simulations, audio clipping, recorded audio file, etc. All these things are clubbed inside this add a content page. Basically, as the name reads, it is to add content in the page. And then the cluster and the question page. Cluster is just a group. What exact group is this? That I will be showing you in the next moment. And then the question page. As I have instructed all the faculty, after adding any single video on any topic, on whatever duration maybe it is, 15 minutes or 20 minutes or 30 minutes or even maybe more than that, we request you to add few questions on that particular video or a topic. This ensures the student's understanding in the topic. If you have 20 videos recorded in this particular reflection of light at curved surfaces top lesson, we simply do not create 20 videos. Instead, in between every single video, we put just for example 5 questions each. So this enables student just not to simply or blindly keep watching any video. We test his understanding after every video that we have uploaded. So this is called decision making exercise. So this will make the decision. What decision? I'll tell you that. So did the student actually understand the video lecture 1 that you have uploaded? Did the student actually upload the video lecture number 2 that you have uploaded? You can actually test it or verify it from adding number of questions. So that is this. So enough of explaining much on this. Let us check inside. Add a content page is the first thing that I would like to do. So just remember, adding this content page is kind of a subtopic in your lesson. For example, in my reflection of light at curved surfaces, I have different topics like spherical surfaces, convex surfaces, concave surfaces, etc. etc. So just for reference, I'll rename this as spherical surfaces. Yeah, in the page content you should be actually writing something related to the spherical surfaces content. Here you have multiple options. If you click here, you can see these many. You must be having a doubt. Should I teach the student in the form of a text, image, video lecture, or any other stuff? You can go multimedia. So please be noted, you can type anything here that will be displayed to the student. Also, you can add an image. You can directly insert an image here. I am clicking browse repositories, choose a file. I can choose any desired file here. Yeah, see, I am just clicking on a random image. I am uploading this image here. It is asking me to choose a size. So randomly I will give some size here and save image. So here I can actually click where I want to display this image. I wanted it in the middle. Save image. So description is not necessary, hence I am saving this image. You see, the first what we have typed is displayed above, and below we have the inserted image. And then if you wanted to type anything again here, you can again type here. There isn't any constraint. Yeah, and similarly, if you want to insert a video beneath this, you can do that. You can do n number of ways of doing it there. You can actually convert any text into a heading. If you wanted to convert this as a heading, I'll go choose a small heading. Yeah, you see, this became a small heading, and this is of different font size that you can manage. And for equation editor, if it is just in case mathematics, you have all the equation editor, you have all the different mathematics symbols needed. Less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, symbols, alpha, beta, gamma, eta, epsilon, yeah. And also we have integration, summations, differentiations, modulus, square roots. So different options, even you can use them here. Well, so that options are there. So this page content is exclusively for your delivery of the content to the student. Here instead you can, I guess most of the faculties have already shot a video lecture, and that can be pasted here. Alright, yeah, I'll move on to the next option that we have. Please do not forget to at least enter the content 1 and 2 that you have here. What should you actually enter here? So just remember previous, type previous here, and in the jump section do not forget to choose previous page. This and this should be synchronous. And in the next description, just type next, and do not forget, ensure this is in the next page. So these two should be also synchronous. So previous page to the previous to the previous page, next to the next page, and click save. Congratulations, you have successfully created your content number 1, that is spherical surfaces. And then let me create one more content page, because a lesson is not limited just with one content page. I can actually choose n number of contents. So add a content page again. So here let me say I'll go with some convex shapes. I'll write something here. Instead of writing something, what I do, I'll paste a video link. So now all the New Vision faculty are submitting the short recorded, pre-recorded video lectures to the technical department, so that they are already compressing the videos to a better quality and size, that they are uploading it to a particular cloud space. That cloud space is being managed by your technical team. So that technical team will have the URL for your video, and they will be pasting it in this particular section. So here you see, you can actually paste a link here. So I have some YouTube link only. I'm just pasting for your reference. I can click create link. I'm done. So I have pasted a video lecture there on convex shapes. This is only for your example, yeah. And then again the same old story, previous to previous page, next to next page. So these two elements I will be entering without committing any mistake or error, and I give save page. You see, I have created two topics now. That is, content one is spherical surfaces, content two is convex surfaces. I will go create another one. I'm sorry. I'll create the next content page. So this time I will be choosing some concave shapes. Yeah, here again the same, previous to previous page, next to next page, and then I'll give save. So successfully I have created three different video lectures. I'm sorry, I have forgot to paste any link here. So just for an example, I'll again click paste some video link here, create link. Okay, alright. So I have done three contents. So we have just discussed before, we should not blindly create n number of topics just like this and go delivering only video lectures. We should add something in between these two content pages. That is, let us add at least five questions. Five questions let us add in between. So to add in between these two, I'll first click on this add a new page and I'll select add a cluster. So I have added a cluster here. So you see, between the spherical surfaces and convex, we have brought in cluster. So not to get confused, I'll go click on the settings gear and rename this cluster as cluster number 1. And I'll click save. You see, I have renamed it. I have not done anything, just renamed it. After this cluster, I should add question number 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So add a question page. What should I choose? Let me choose a multiple choice question. So the page title, let me put question number 1. And here I should actually paste the question. So what question? So I have made some rough arrangements here. So I have some random questions not related to this topic. So I have copied that first question and I'm pasting the question here. This is only the question. And since I have chosen multiple choice, option A I should enter here. Option A is this, rest. Paste it here. And you see, the answer here is A. Rest is the correct answer. So what I do here, the score will be 1 because this is the correct answer. Next option is motion. Yeah, motion I have pasted here. Motion is a wrong answer, hence I have chosen 0. And option C, can't say. Something is written there, can't say. And again, can't say is wrong option, so I will not change the value. The last option is some, what shall we write, all of the above or none of the above. Again, this is not a correct option, hence I have chosen something like this, 0. So before I save this page, there is one more setting that I should change for every single answer that I have marked here. You see, there is an option called jump. You should actually modify that to cluster 1. Yeah, I have created cluster 1 if you remember just before. Similarly, here cluster 1. Again at the option 3, cluster 1. Again at option D, cluster 1. Now I am done with all the necessary settings and I click save. Yeah, you see, whatever I have done is reflecting here. Q1 is the question I have given, that I have chosen as a multiple choice one. Four options I have, for every single option I have chosen cluster 1. So successfully I have created question number 1. Instead of again creating the same from here, add a question page and doing this blah blah blah, there is an option for me here, duplicate this Q1 page. I'll click on this. So this is duplicating the first option here. Now I'll go simply edit this. Yeah, I'll modify this to Q2. Now here give your question number 2. Here let me say this is my question number 2. I'll paste that here. So paste your four options here. Rest motion, can't say, something relative, absolute. So just please modify all the options here for your new question. And do not forget to keep them as cluster 1. I have done all the necessary changes. In my question, for example, this particular question, if rest is the answer, I'll leave that as score 1 and I'll go click save. If not, I'll modify that. So you see, Q1 is created, Q2 is created. Similar way, I would like to create 3 more. Yeah, so this is not any rule, but this is just a recommendation that we are asking you to create at least 3 questions to test the understanding of the student. Okay, so you see, this is Q3. I'll duplicate 2 more times and again rename that. Q3 will be renamed to Q4. You're getting me? So Q4 is done. And one more question, I can complete my 5 questions list. The targeted 5. Q5. Yeah, alright. Just click on save. And before, after this question number 5 and before this content number 2, I should do one more change, that is ending a cluster. Add an end of cluster. If you remember, after the spherical shapes, I have started a cluster. I have started a cluster and marked it as cluster number 1. So since I have added 5 questions and I have ended a cluster, I should end it, and let me rename that to avoid confusion. Cluster number 1 again. Save page. So what is a cluster? So now cluster starting, cluster ending. This is just grouping your 5 questions. So cluster is a group. So this cluster, this all these options must be in a group. All these should be in clusters. With this, you have successfully completed your cluster 1. You can move on to the next content page. Similarly, in between your content page, you should again create 5 more questions and you should be starting and ending your cluster pages. Yeah, that's great. So let me add you. So yeah, so this is a repetitive process where we will be adding Q1 to Q5 between any 2 content pages. Let me just quickly, let us assume that there are questions between these 2 pages. So with that assumption, I'll go create one more content page to demonstrate 2 more ideas. So you see, after these convex shapes, I have duplicated these. Let me rename one of them to activities. Yeah, I'll save this. And the last one, I'll rename it to, for example, solar cell or something. Yeah. I have clicked save. So now you see, I have created content 1, 2, 3, 4 and plus 1 on the top, total 5 content pages. So there is one particular question from one of the faculties. For example, you have in one particular topic 30 to 40 videos. Yeah, you have already recorded them. A student is watching them one by one. If a student particularly wants to directly jump to a topic, for example, convex shapes or activities or a solar cell, how should he actually do? So to answer you that, first we should see how this actually is visible to the student. Please come and click on the preview button here. So here in the first page, I have typed spherical surfaces as a heading and I have written some content, inserted a photo and a normal text. So we have created 2 buttons. Let me click on the next button. So I have given 5 questions and 5 questions comes like this. I should give answer So student will be answering all these questions to enter into the next topic. So this is how they will be answering, and then he will be entering after finishing the 5 questions to this convex shapes. Here we have inserted a video. You see, some random video I have inserted, and if I click next, it takes me to another video, because we have given another kind of a, assume this is a video lecture, and then convex shapes activities, another video lecture here, and then the click another video lecture here for the solar cell. So a student must keep selecting next and previous buttons to watch the upcoming next video or go to the previous video. He can click on the previous and watch the previous video as well. Yeah, the previous video is activities type. So if you want a table of contents before beginning this lesson, you can actually do that. So let me go back, click on the edit page. Before creating the spherical surfaces, I'll add one new content page. Yeah, so this new content page, I'll name it as table of contents. So if you would like to write something here, you can write, dear student, select your desired subtopic to learn. Something I have written here. And then in the content 1, so you have already seen I have certain subtopics. First one is spherical. So in the jump option, I will select spherical surfaces. In the content 2, let me write convex. And in the jump section, I will select convex shapes. In content 3, I'll give concave, and here I'll click concave shapes. In the content 4, I'll give activities and click on activities page. Similarly at content 5, what is the other one, solar cell, something I've written, solar cell I'll be selecting. I'll give click save page. Yeah, so this table of contents is now second in my queue. I would like to reposition it. I'll click on this arrow mark, and I would like to move it above the spherical surfaces. So I'll click on move page to here. So you see now table of contents, and then our lesson is beginning. So I'll go click and see the preview now. Yeah, so once a student enters this reflection of light at curved surfaces topic, he will see these options. If he clicks on concave, it will directly take him to the concave topic. You see the concave shapes. You got me? So from here the student can keep continue reading the lesson. In here, along with previous next and next buttons, you can also put another button here to table of contents. That is optional. That is to the choice of the faculty. So let me see concave shapes, convex shapes, and I'll add third content. This is table of contents. Here I'll select table of contents, and I'll click save page. So let us go see preview of this page. I'll click on preview. Yes, so this is my convex shapes. I have 3 buttons, one to go to the previous video, one to go to the next video, and one directly take me to the table of contents. Yes, yeah, you see I have come back to the contents page. Now if I want to directly go to solar cells, I can actually go there. So this is how we actually manage. That is the whole idea of these table of contents, clusters, and then different topics in this lesson creation. So this is how you will be actually creating a lesson, and these lessons will be seen by the student in a regular order. You should actually plan before you begin any content of a lesson. you know, if you want the student to do it in a constructive way, constructive learning, so you should, the student should actually go topic by topic. So that is video lecture by one, lecture by lecture. So if you have lecture 20, so video lecture 1, after he watching the video lecture 1, he'll be moving on to the questions in the cluster. After he answers, he'll be moving on to the page number 2, that is video lecture number 2. Video lecture number 2, then to the video lecture number 3, 4, 5, 6, in a constructive way. He'll be doing this way. It is your choice. If you wanted to put something like this, if I'm a novice guy, that is I'm a beginner, and I directly wanted to view solar cells without knowing any of these type of contents inside, yes, you can definitely do that. So, yeah. So, this is the whole features that are involved inside these content creation. So, as I said before, you can go multimedia, you can insert a video, you can insert an image, you can insert a GIF file or any graphs, mathematical equations, physics equations, chemistry, any type of mappings. You can actually do multiple things inside this content. Yeah, that is how you will be actually creating this entire lesson. So do not forget, after finishing adding all the content pages, you should actually end this lesson. Ending this lesson, you have end of lesson page. You should just click on the settings gear, and then in the content 2, instead of giving next, there will be an option called end of lesson. So once the student clicks on this end of lesson, he will be prompted a message that you have successfully completed the whole reflection of light at curved surfaces topic. This concludes a lesson for the student. Cheers to all the faculty for creating this lesson, and this students who are participating in this course must be feeling really happy, because they'll be having a constructive way of learning. And just to give you a certain idea, all the faculties will have a button here, reports, and if the students start learning content from your page, you can actually get some statistics here in very granular level, let's say in 2-digit percentages, you can get it here. So that's how. Yeah. So this concludes my tutorial on how to create a lesson inside a course. Yeah. Cheers all of you. Thank you. Thanks for your time. Signing off.